Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Tum English. I am Pradosh Sharma, and you are watching News Flash. Justice Sanjeev Khanna took oath as India's 51st Chief Justice, succeeding D.Y. Chandrachud, administered by President Draupadi Murmu. Justice Khanna's term will last until May 13, 2025, following key rulings on issues like Article 370 and electoral bonds. Kuki militants attacked Mehdi villages in East Imphal, leading to prolonged gunfire near BSF outposts. The violence, initially targeting Mongbang, spread to Thamna Pokpi and Sabungkhog before BSF intervened. The Supreme Court criticized the lax enforcement of Delhi's firecracker ban, urging NCR states to control pollution from firecrackers and stubble burning after Diwali's pollution spike. Gurpatwant Pannu of SFG issued threats against Hindus, MPs and temples, prompting India to label these acts as terror. SFG plans protests at Hindu temples on November 16 and 17. Russia refuted US media claims of a call between Trump and Putin over Ukraine, labeling the report completely false. Bangladesh Awami League staged anti-government protests under strict security as BJP platoon secured the city, while arrest of Awami League workers continue. After registering a historic victory in the general elections of Mauritius, Prime Minister Narendra Modi congratulated Dr. Naveen Ramgoolam, who is all set to become the new Prime Minister of Mauritius. At a summit in Riyadh, Saudi leaders urged ceasefires in Gaza and Lebanon, renewing demands for a Palestinian state amid escalating tensions with Israel. In a major counter-offensive, CRPF killed 10 Kuki militants who reportedly planned an attack on the Jiribam CRPF headquarters, seizing LMGs and INSAS rifles. PM Modi and Russia's first deputy PM Manturov discussed strengthening trade and energy ties following Modi's recent meetings with the President Putin. IAS officials K. Gopalakrishnan and N. Prasanth were suspended by Kerala government for alleged misconduct involving religious and social media issues. A TIS study reveals that illegal immigrants are reshaping Mumbai's socio-economic landscape, causing wage drops and influencing political dynamics. PM Netanyahu confirmed Israel's role in September attacks targeting Hezbollah's Nasrallah, despite internal opposition in Israel's defensive sector. Trump paid Vivek Ramaswamy voice support for mass deportation, calling the US immigration system broken. Over 90 rockets from Lebanon struck near Haifa, northeast Israel, injuring several civilians, with the IDF intercepting the majority of the rockets. President-elect Trump chose US Representative Mike Waltz, known for his hawkish stance on China, as his national security advisor. So that's all for the headlines of the day. For more updates, download the app and keep watching Rhythm.